John here. Welcome to another video. It's a bit of an impromptu video, this. I thought about doing this morning as I was cooling the house down. I go through a bit of a ritual or a process in terms of keeping our house cool, so I thought I would take you through it. And this is how I do it for our house, and everyone's house is different, so take away what you will from that. If you've got any additional tips and ideas and things that work for you, then do drop them down in the comments below so we can share and help each other. So a typical UK house here, or was it that one? No, not that one. Probably this one, or this one. The golden rule that I apply when thinking about keeping the house cool is, if it's hotter outside than inside, then keep all the doors, windows, curtains, blinds closed. If it's hotter inside than outside, then open doors, windows, curtains, blinds. And quite simply, I find that during the day, it's windows closed, doors closed, blinds, everything down. And then in the evening, stroke early morning, before it gets too hot, everything's open. And that's the video. I could do this in a number of seconds, but I shall take you through exactly what happens. Now, it's just not just me that's saying that. There's lots of evidence which supports the fact that once the air temperature outside is warmer than inside, then you need to prevent any more coming in. Because as we all know, that warm air migrates to cold air. And so if it's warm outside, it's cool inside. If you open a window, it'll actually get warmer inside. Even if it's windy, if it's a warm air and windy, it will still get warmer inside. So here's today, actually. I'm recording this on Saturday, the 13th of August. At 7:30 this morning, it was temperature of, not too sure why there's two different temperatures here on this weather station. This is the one just down the road, which I've talked about before, 18 degrees and rising, or 16.5 degrees and also rising, whichever one. But anyway, quite cool comparative for the time of year in terms of what we've been having. In our house, this is sitting in the office. And again, same time, 7:30 in the morning. This is the AirWare device showing 84 as an overall percentage, and that's built up on a combination of these factors. So temperature at 20.5, humidity has been going up to 74%, so quite humid. CO2 levels are okay, chemicals are okay, and PM2.5 is also okay. So that's where we started. But the temperature is really the one I'm concentrating on. So I opened all of the doors and windows. So opening the front door, office window, the kitchen window. We've also got 6 meters of patio doors, which we can slide open one at a time. And then all upstairs, all the windows are open and the shutters away from those windows where applicable. Apart from that, middle window there, which seems to have closed itself. A bit of a breeze sometimes, and closed the shutter. So this is a view from inside looking out. So the principle here is to vent the house and drop the temperature inside the house. And if you have got the facility to be able to do that through the house from front to back or back to front, depending on which way the wind's blowing, side to side, then that's perfect. So here, it's looking to the front of the house. Those two windows on the bay there are open and blowing through the doors, and they meet up with the dining room, which has already got the 6 meter doors already open. Here, the front door's open into the hallway, into the sort of kitchen stroke TV room. Same with the utility room, have the door open. Moving upstairs, we have the loft hatch open. And generally, I'll keep that open all the time. So again, if it's hotter outside than inside, I'll keep that open because that acts as a bit of a chimney and draws the hot air up through into the loft space. And as we all know, as I said earlier, hot air rises. So it sucks it through there rather than staying in the upper layer in the top of the house, in the bedrooms and the landing. Oh, this is the downstairs toilet. So again, windows open, office from the inside, upstairs. So just just pictures of open windows, which I'm sure you've probably seen before. Look, there's an open window. Oh, look, there's a view outside of the window. So yeah, we're just venting the house, getting rid of all of the excess heat that's built up overnight. And the doors and windows, by and large, upstairs have been open all night, but the downstairs ones haven't, obviously. A bit of a security risk, leaving your front door open all night and the back one. So generally when we get up in the morning, the top of the house is really nice and cool, but the bottom of the house needs a vent to cool it down. And that's really what we're doing. So we work through that. So this is from Home Assistant. This is the temperature sensor in the office. I know it says at the top there glass temperature. Eventually this temperature gauge will be going into the glass studio, but at the moment it's sitting in the office. So at 8 minutes past seven, which is a very precise time, it was 21.5 degrees in the office. By the time I'd done a bit of venting and cooling down, by 8 o'clock, just under an hour, it had already dropped to 19.9 degrees. And it may not sound a lot, but a 1 degree temperature change is quite significant, and you do feel the difference. Plus you've got a constant cool draft. So I keep my eye on that and I monitor the temperature. So here is 10 o'clock and you can see the temperature now is 24.9, almost 25 degrees or 26, depending on which one you look at, and rising over the course of the morning. And this is still just 10 o'clock in the morning. So let's have a little look at my next stage. I keep an eye on that temperature, and once it gets too hot, I know it's hotter outside than it is inside. So I now go to batten down the hatches, as it were. So this is a schematic of our downstairs. Bottom of the plan there is facing south. So we're directly, well, south-southwest, south. And the front of the house, where the hall is and the lounge bay window, is facing north. So what I do is I close the back part of the house. So the double doors there, which are circled in red, which are these French doors here, from the dining room into the lounge. Same again with the set of French doors from the TV room stroke kitchen into the hall. This is the view from the hall looking back into that room. And then also do the same with the kitchen door into the hallway. And again, this is in the hallway looking back into the kitchen. You just see the fridge in the background there. And then I go round and shut everything that I can, basically. So the blinds on these doors, patio doors, 6 meter doors. We've also got some Velux blinds on our 6 Velux windows. And they're really good because they block out 90% of the heat, but still let in a good amount of light. So as you can see there, you still get the light in, but you don't get the heat. So we go around, shut all the windows, put down the shutters all the way around, front and, well, back and front, as you can see there. And that gives you a very nice interior. The loft hatch, as you can see there, is still left open just to suck up any warm air that comes into the house. But I've now basically got two zones in the house, certainly downstairs. A temperate zone towards the back of the house, which heats up, and then at the front of the house, it is really, really cool. And it's a noticeable difference between the two parts of the house. So the hall, office, WC, and the lounge is very, very cool. And you'll see that in a minute when we look at the temperature. Whereas the kitchen / family room does get quite hot, even with all the blinds down. So we come back looking at the temperature. At midday, we're running about 29 degrees in outside. In the office, the airway at midday is showing 81%, which is broken down to a temperature of 22.6. And the office, if you recall, has three sides to it, so it's open on three sides, so it's not a particularly well placed or positioned building. Actually, the rest of the house in the cool bit is actually cooler than it certainly feels a lot cooler than the office, even though the office is a lot cooler than outside. It's 29 outside, 22.6 in the office. And then compare that to early on at 7:30 in the morning, it's only risen 2 degrees over the course of sort of 6 hours, and that's probably as high as it will go. It might get to 23. It really maintains a good temperature in the house without the need for any fans or air conditioning units or anything like that. It's just purely using the sort of thermodynamics and available options within the house to keep the house cool. And even the cat likes it, so she finds the cool spot. In this case, she's in the hallway on the stairs, and she'll be there all day because it's the coolest part of the house. So, any questions, do drop down to the comments and ask them down there, and I'll pick them up. And as I said right at the beginning, if you've got any thoughts, any ideas, any tricks and tips that you use, then please add them into the comments down below. And I will see you on the next video. All right, thanks for watching. Take care. Bye.